It's time for us to begin. Welcome to everybody. We're glad to have you with us. Some of you have traveled a good distance to be here. Happy to have you with us. I'm just trying to think, Beach, you may get the award for that. B.G. Murphy is here and she lives in, I don't know if it's Memphis or Mississippi, but Memphis metropolitan area. We're glad to have you with us. And it's always a pleasure to have Rod back with us. He does such a great job with this. So let's begin this evening, and I'm going to let you remain seated, but Chris Blotman is going to read from an extended passage in Ephesians chapter 5. So Chris, if you would come up here and do that, and then we'll open with a word prayer, and then we'll turn it over to Rod. And I think it's good to have Stephen in the booth tonight. He's going to orchestrate things from back there. And I think all of the songs are on the screen except for a couple.
Having technical difficulties.
Okay, Chris.
All right, I'll be reading from Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 through 21. Follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But among you, there must not be even a hint of sexual immorality or of any kind of impurity or of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people. Nor should there be obscenity, foolish talk, or coarse joking, which are out of place, but rather thanksgiving. For of this you can be sure. No immoral, impure, or greedy person, such as a person is an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no one deceive you with empty words. For because of such things, God's wrath comes on those who are disobedient. Therefore, do not be partners with them. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light, for the fruit of the light consists in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And find out what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them. It is shameful even to mention what the disobedient do in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, and everything that is illuminated becomes a light. This is why it is said, wake up, sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you. Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking at one another with psalms, hymns, and songs of the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. All right, let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for allowing us all be able to make it here this evening and gather with one another and help us to fellowship and make a joyful noise to you this evening. Thank you for all the blessings that you've given us and be with those who are traveling and aren't able to be here. In Jesus' name, amen.
You know, I love the theme that you have tonight for Songs of Light, Portrait of Discipleship. These songs talk about a lot of different things that remind us of what discipleship is. Give us little snapshots of discipleship. I know the first song that we're going to sing has to do with grace. You know, it's grace. It talks about in this verse that we'll read, that this grace is what saves us through faith. But it also moves us to be like Christ, to live a life that reflects Him. And the verse in Titus says, "For the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, godly lives in this present age." If you understand the depth and the beauty and the wonder of His grace, it really does move you to live a life like that in order to worship God and give Him honor and give Him praise. And these first two songs talk about His grace. Let's stand together. We're going to sing, "He Gave Me a Song and the Wonderful Grace of Jesus." Are you ready? Okay. "He took my burdens all away.
Brighter the way grows every day. Walking up ahead. Songs and honor sounding loud.
Again, a wonderful song of praise to God. I'm going to lead it kind of, but Zoe Gould is actually going to lead it audibly. There we go. Okay. We're going to play the music, and we're going to sing along with the music, and you can see yourself on the screen. So, Stephen, if you want to go ahead and start that, let's sing that together.
You were the Word of the beginning.
I love you.
himself for us to redeem us from all wickedness and to purify for himself a people that are his very own, eager to do what is good. That describes a life in Christ, a life that wants to honor God by letting their light shine before men, that they might see their good works and give glory to God. And so we're going to sing songs of redemption. And if it's convenient, I'm going to ask you to stand. We're going to sing Heaven Came Down and He Bore It All. So let's stand together if you're able. And we're going to do these songs back to back. But you are very good. All right, here we go.
Oh, what a tender compassion, friend, even the deal.
seated. I just enjoy hearing you sing. I think I'm going to stop singing. Here's a couple of wonderful hymns that talk about redemption. And again, we're going to sing these back to back. First is Redeemed and The Great Redeemer. Now, one of these, yeah, I'll let you turn to 450. Yeah, I remember there were two songs. So, everybody find the hymnal?
Oh.
Psalms 33, 20 through 22 talks about another characteristic of discipleship. And that is when we are saved by grace through faith, to follow Him and to give Him praise, and to trust in His leading, to be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. This psalm reminds us that it is by depending upon Him that we actually make it through this. Depending upon His strength, upon His leading. Psalms 33 says, we depend upon the Lord alone to save us. Only He can help us. He protects us like a shield. No wonder we are happy with the Lord. For we are trusting in Him. We trust His holy name. Yes, Lord, let Your constant love surround us. For our hopes are in You alone. I'm going to ask Mike to come up and lead us in prayer. And then we're going to sing songs that deal with depending upon God.
Let's bow. Oh, Heavenly Father, thank You for giving us the time and the freedom to come and worship You, to sing these songs to You, that You are the great Redeemer of all. That, Lord, it is only by grace that we have been saved. And, Lord, that makes our hearts happy as we go about the days in the world around us. Lord, we just want to thank You for Jesus and His precious gift to us of that dying on the cross and saving us. Lord, help us as we continue to praise You tonight through our songs. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
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 heart of pain and pleasure, mingling joy with peace and rest. Every day, the Lord Himself is near me, with a special mercy for each other. All my cares, He wants to bear to cheer me. He whose name is Counselor and God. The protection of His child and treasure,
that's such a testimony to the world of the power of Jesus and the power of the Spirit in our lives to give us peace in the midst of storm and in the midst of trials. People look at that and it's hard for them to understand how that's possible to not be ruled by our circumstances. But they want that. We want to be able to have the strength and the courage and the ability to overcome like that. And this song speaks to why.
Master, the tempest is raging, the billows are tossing high. The sky is overshadowed with gladness, no shelter or help is nigh. Carest thou not that we perish? How can thou lie asleep? When each moment so madly is threatening, a ring in the angry deep. The winds and the waves shall obey thy will.
Please, Jesus, be still.
When the breath of the storm tossed sea, or demons or men or whatever it be, no water can swallow the ship without the master of ocean and earth and skies. They all shall sweetly obey thy will. Peace be still, peace be still. They all shall sweetly obey. Master, with anguish of spirit, I bow in my grief today. The depths of my sad heart are troubled. Awaken and save, I pray. Torrents of sin and of anguish sweep o'er my sinking soul.
This last scripture that I want to read for you is comes from 1 Peter 4, 10 and 11. And this part of discipleship, this snapshot of discipleship, has to do with service. Calling us to a life of service, to emulate Christ. He was one who came to serve. And that is our calling as well. Each one of us should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. If anyone speaks, you should do so as one who speaks the very words of God. If anyone serves, they should do it with the strength God provides so that all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ. To Him be the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen. A beautiful day. Isn't that the most obnoxious which Mike you've ever heard? All right, here we go. But it's useful. It does the trick. It does what we need it to do. Here we go.
Each day I'll do.
Rainbows so they can sing one more.
Yeah, let's do that. All right, hey,
Can you bring them up front, brother?
I need you want to bring them up front? Yeah. They're all your kids and grandkids, right? Awesome. I need a hymn.
It's not in that one.
It's not in this one?
No.
All right. So yeah.
Yes.
Hymn, I'll take two. Hey, do you have the...
We're just taking one verse.
Yeah.
Just one verse?
Just the first verse.
I don't know if I need this. Well, I just know you got to work for grooming Lucas for that question.
Hey, I'm more than capable, aren't you? You guys ready? We're going to do Blue Skies and Rainbows. Now, y'all can sing too.
Lord, you know.
We'll start again with sopranos, then we'll add the altos second time, and then we'll add the tenors, and then the bass. And again, we'll repeat it one time at the end, and it needs to be double fortissimo, which means loud. So here we go. Starting with sopranos. No, wrong note. You don't want to sing that note. You want to sing this note. He has the marvelous, he has the marvelous things. Praise the Lord. Just sopranos again. He has the marvelous, he has the marvelous things. Praise the Lord.
Strengthen our fellowship. It's in your name we pray. Amen.